in terms of things that are important in life, after the basics of food and water and shelter, art is in fact one of the most important things, because they are the means with which to study and understand the nature of being human and what it all entails. And it's the enrichment of the arts that people get from it that makes me want to be involved.
Not only do we have to keep our kids well fed, but we have to feed their souls in order for them to thrive. By bringing in the Visiting Artist Series in collaboration with Icicle Creek Center for the Arts, we give kids and their families an opportunity to see world-class performers with life-changing performances. It only takes one experience for someone where the light bulb goes on and it changes their life.
I asked my students, so why should people support the arts? One of them said they should support the arts because it encourages kids to try things they thought they couldn't do. So a little first grader raised his hand and said, yeah, like Mrs. Keene, after the blind pianist was here, he said, I went home and told my mom, Mom, I want to play piano. And he's taking piano lessons now.
To have something like Icicle Creek within a small community is phenomenal. For the art education piece especially, you know, these are kids that might not have opportunity to do that elsewhere. Teaching a kid that they can better themselves through music or through, you know, film. If they can find love at an early age for whatever they're doing, then they'll grow up and you know, contribute to society in their own way.
I don't know why you wouldn't want to support Icicle Creek Center for the Arts, just because every performance speaks to so many different people.
We have a world-class venue right down the street from us. You know, we're lucky enough that the foundation has been built for us, and it's our responsibility to make sure that we sustain that. So, you know, our kids can have this for their families.
We need to have the arts as part of our culture and life in this area, and we're very fortunate that we have ICCA, and we need to support it and build it and keep it viable.
Help to nourish the souls of our students in this community and support Icicle Creek Center for the Arts and the work that they do in our region, because it can't happen without you.
Hi everyone, my name is Oksana Jokina and I'm Artistic Director of the Chamber Music Festival and Institute here at Icicle Creek Center for the Arts. It's my great pleasure to welcome you to the third virtual Chamber Music Festival concert of 2020. It's been amazing to see how many of you have tuned in to hear the first and the second concerts, and I hope that we see more of you and more of your friends, so please invite anybody you can think of who might be interested in joining us virtually for the next 2.5 weeks. I would like to give a few thanks. First of all, to those of you who have so generously donated to Icicle Creek Center for the Arts. As you know, we are a nonprofit organization and we are immensely appreciative of any financial support you can offer us so we can continue the programming. Second of all, I would like to thank Classic Pianos of Bellevue. You can probably see their insignia on the side of the piano. This beautiful Yamaha was delivered today and it's an incredible instrument that's really fantastic to play on, so we're all here very delighted to have it. So thank you so much, Classic Pianos of Bellevue. Last but not least, I wanted to highlight a couple of programmatic elements and connections on this program that you're about to hear. As many of you know, 2020 was supposed to be a big Beethoven year, and of course he's getting kind of a bummer of a birthday due to the global pandemic, but we're still including his music on these concerts, and you will hear his last sonata for violin and piano, Opus 96. And curiously, you'll also hear his very first violin sonata in one of the later concerts. It just so happens, soon you will hear his first trio, Opus 1, number 1, and then also his last major work, Archduke, in the course of these programs. I'm telling you this so you will return and bring your friends with you. And also, another wonderful work on this concert is a piece called Summerland by William Grant Still. William Grant Still was an incredibly prolific composer with some 200 plus works. He was called the Dean of Afro-American Music. He wrote in all genres and in all styles. And we're so immensely happy to present this piece for you. It's kind of a transcription. It exists in many different forms for piano and violin and piano. And tonight you will hear it on cello and piano with David Rokir and myself. Once again, thank you so much for everything you do for us. And we hope to see you on concert 4, 5, etc. until the end of this virtual Chamber Music Festival.
Hello, everyone. And welcome to the third Virtual Chamber Music Festival concert. My name is Camila Dota and I play cello. I have been a student at Icicle Creek Chamber Music Festival in years 2018 and 2019. And I am very thrilled to introduce the concert today. The artists will include Marie Wang and Hurik Puchikian on violin, Oksana Zhokina on piano, and Meta Weiss and David Rokiro on cello. The program is Beethoven Sonata for Violin and Piano in G Major, Opus 96, William Grant's Still, Summerland for Cello and Piano, Isai Sonata for Solo Violin, Opus 27, No. 2, and Solima, Arboreto Salvatico for two cellos. I hope you enjoy the concert, and I hope you tune in for our next concert on July 21st at 5 p.m. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.